Oh, drat these computers. They're so naughty and so complex. I could pinch them.
What's up, everyone, and welcome. Today, we're going to talk about a company called Palantir. A computer glitch in a secretive software program used by the FBI allowed some unauthorized employees to access private data for more than a year, prosecutors revealed in a new court filing. The screw-up in the Palantir program, a software created by a sprawling data analytics company co-founded by billionaire Peter Thiel, was detailed in a letter by prosecutors in the Manhattan federal court case against accused hacker Virgil Griffith. Data recovered from Griffith's Facebook and Twitter accounts, which was obtained through a federal search warrant in March 2020, was accessed on Palantir for more than a year by at least four FBI employees, all of whom work outside New York and were not investigating the case. The FBI case agent assigned to Griffith's case was alerted to the unauthorized access earlier this month when another agent emailed him and said an analyst accessed the search warrant material on Palantir, according to the letter. An FBI analyst, in the course of conducting a separate investigation, had identified communications between the defendant and the subject of that other investigation by means of searches on the platform that accessed the search warrant returns, the feds wrote in the letter filed Tuesday. Federal prosecutors in Manhattan determined the FBI employees, three analysts and an agent, were able to view the material because it was entered in Palantir through the program's default settings. When data is loaded onto the platform, the default setting is to permit access to the data to other FBI personnel otherwise authorized to access the platform, prosecutors wrote in the letter. The material was accessed at least four times from May 2020 to August 2021, according to the letter. In a statement, a Palantir spokesperson said the error was caused by the FBI. There was no glitch in the software. Our platform has robust access and security controls. The customer also has rigorous protocols established to protect search warrant returns, which, in this case, the end user did not follow, the spokesperson from Palantir says. Griffith, in case you don't know, is accused of violating international sanctions by traveling to North Korea and delivering a speech about cryptocurrency. He pleaded not guilty after his arrest in 2019 and was subsequently ordered held in jail pending his trial this year, according to court filings. Now, for some, the story would just end there. But for me, it only starts me thinking how the FBI and the US government is using companies like Palantir to gather massive amounts of data on its citizens.
Say, pay attention, boys.
Now, Palantir is a public American software company that specializes in big data analytics. Headquartered in Denver, Colorado, it was founded by Peter Thiel, Nathan Geddings, Joe Lonsdale, Stephen Cohen, and Alex Karp in 2003. 2003? That's like the Stone Age for the internet. Big data analytics in 2003? So we know that they have lots and lots of practice and lots of data. The company's name is derived from The Lord of the Rings, where the magical palantíri, where seeing stones, or were seeing stones, described as indestructible balls of crystal used for communications to see events in other parts of the world. Now that's kind of creepy. But the firm, sometimes described as the scariest of America's tech giants, got its start working with U.S. soldiers in Iraq and Afghanistan, but now supplies software to police departments, other public agencies, and corporate clients. It is active in more than 150 countries, including the UK, where it was one of the tech firms the government enlisted in 2020 to help respond to coronavirus. But Palantir's rise has been shattered by concerns from privacy experts who say the firm's tools enable surveillance and analysis of data, everything from driver's license and social media posts to DNA swabs. That skirts people's right to privacy and is ripe for abuse. In the US, the use of its technology by immigration authorities to help round up undocumented immigrants has drawn heated protests, and in the UK, the health data handled by the firm has also raised alarms. Ahead of the firm's public listing, Amnesty International issued a report saying the firm was failing its responsibility as a company to protect human rights with inadequate due diligence into who it is working for. Palantir told Amnesty that it had deliberately declined some work with border authorities in the U.S. due to those concerns. But the company has also vigorously defended its government work, maintaining that its clients own and control the data. It says it has a team focused on civil liberties issues, but it is the government's job to craft policy, not Silicon Valley's. It has contrasted its commitment to some other tech firms, such as Google, which stopped work on an artificial intelligence project with the Pentagon after a backlash from employees. Now, Palantir's original clients were federal agencies of the USIC. It has since expanded its customer base to serve state and local governments, as well as private companies in the financial and healthcare industries. Palantir developed its original technology by computer scientists and analysts from intelligence agencies over 3 years through pilots facilitated by InQtel. The company stated computers alone using artificial intelligence could not defeat an adaptive adversary. Instead, Palantir proposed using human analysts to explore data from many sources called intelligence augmentation. Now, the company is known for three projects in particular. There's Palantir Gotham, Palantir Metropolis, and Palantir Foundry. Palantir Gotham is used by counterterrorism analysts at offices in the United States Intelligence Community, that's the USIC, and United States Department of Defense. In the past, Gotham was used by fraud investigators at the Recovery, Accountability, and Transparency Board, a former U.S. federal agency which operated from 2009 to 2015. Gotham was also used by cyber analysts at Information Warfare Monitor, a Canadian public-private venture, which operated from 2003 to 2012. Palantir's other product, Metropolis, is used by hedge funds, banks, and financial services firms. Now, Palantir Foundry is used by corporate clients such as Morgan Stanley, Merck KGaA, Airbus, and Fiat Chrysler Automobiles, and V. In 2009 and 2010, respectively, Information Warfare Monitor used Palantir software to uncover the GhostNet and Shadow Network. GhostNet was a China-based cyber espionage network targeting 1,295 computers in 103 countries, including the Dalai Lama's office, a NATO computer, and various national embassies. The Shadow Network was also a China-based espionage operation that hacked into the Indian security and defense apparatus. Cyber spies stole documents related to Indian security and NATO troop activity in Afghanistan. In April 2010, Palantir announced a partnership with Thomson Reuters to sell the Palantir Metropolis product as QA Studio, or Quantitative Analysis Tool. On June 18, 2010, when then Vice President Joe Biden and Office of Management and Budget Director Peter Orszag held a press conference at the White House announcing the success of fighting fraud in the stimulus that was done for the 2008 crash by the Recovery and Accountability and Transparency Board, Biden credited the success to Palantir's QA Studio software being deployed by the federal government. He announced that the capability will be deployed at other government agencies, starting with Medicare and Medicaid. Now, a document leaked to TechCrunch revealed that Palantir's clients as of 2013 included at least 12 groups within the U.S. government, including CIA, DHS, NSA, FBI, CDC, the Marine Corps, the Air Force, Special Operations Command, West Point, the Joint Improvised Threat Detection Organization, and their allies, the Recovery, Accountability, and Transparency Board, and the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children. Also, according to TechCrunch, the U.S. spy agencies such as CIA and FBI were linked for the first time with Palantir software, as their original databases had previously been silent. I have to admit, it's not all bad. Palantir, as I briefly mentioned in the beginning, was one of four large technology firms to work with the NHS on supporting COVID-19 efforts through the provision of software from Palantir Foundry, and by April 2020, several countries had used Palantir technology to track and contain the contagion. Palantir also developed Tiberius, a software for vaccine allocation used in the United States. But even in the good details, there is the potential for very dark usage. Palantir's Foundry was used to track and contain the contagion of COVID. This could easily be used for evil deeds. So be careful and keep your eye on Palantir and who they work for. You know, we talk about Pegasus infecting your phone and spying on you, but I see parallels between the capabilities of Palantir software and Pegasus, even though Palantir doesn't infect your phone. They still have so much data on you that they could easily do the same kind of surveillance, or similar kinds of surveillance. So with that, thanks for watching. Don't forget to share and subscribe and smash the bell, and I will see you on the next episode. Take care. Ha 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 ha
get to run!